Okay, let's look at in a waveform way how frequency modulation occurs. So let's say you have a square signal like this from AM to minus AM, okay, and your carrier signal is like this, cosine signal from AC to minus AC. Then if you will take the frequency modulated wave, this is how it will look like. So you can see for plus 1 you plus AM, you saw there are more number of cycles, and for minus AM there are less number of cycles of carrier signals. Okay, so you can say F1 is greater than FC and F2 is less than FC. How I am judging? The more number of cycles, the more the value of frequency. Okay, the less number of cycles in the time period, then less frequency. So you can see it is comparing to the normal carrier signal, the frequency of this signal in this time domain is greater than FC, and frequency is less than FC in this time domain. So you can see F1 is equal to FI is equal to FC plus KF AM, F2 is equal to FI is equal to FC minus KF AM. That is how you can imagine. Okay. Similarly, if you will have a message signal like this, for this part of the message signal, it will have more frequencies. For this part of the signal, it will have less frequencies, and so on. You can imagine. That is how frequency modulated signal will look like if you modulate the carrier signal with respect to message, with respect to frequency. Okay. Let's look at the generalized expression of frequency modulated signal. So assume you have a carrier signal before modulation. It is represented by CT, where CT is your AC cos 2 pi FCT plus phi, where FC is frequency, S phi is as phase. Now you can write it as AC cos theta T, where theta T is your 2 pi FC T plus phi. Now if you differentiate this theta T with respect to T, what you will get is 2 pi FC, because this is a constant and this is constant 0, and this is a constant with t, so 2 pi fct. So generalized expression of fm is given as s fm t is equal to ac cos theta I t, where theta I t is instantaneous angle. Now in this way you can write d theta I t divided by dt is equal to 2 pi fi, okay, where fi you can arrange it 1 by 2 pi d theta I t divided by dt. Sometimes this comes in handy when you are solving numericals. Now fi, now here theta I, again you can write it as theta I is equal to 2 pi integration fi dt. Now if you plug the value of fi, that is fc plus kf mt, you will get 2 pi fc t plus 2 pi kf integration mt dt. Now again this value of theta I you put here, you will get the generalized expression of FM signal, which is SFMT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integration MT DT. This is your generalized expression for FM signal. Okay, this is how it comes. So we'll be mostly dealing this equation. Now let's take a single tone case where MT is AM cos 2 pi FMT and your FM signal is AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integration MT DT. If you plug the value of MT here, you'll get AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF AM sin 2 pi FMT divided by 2 pi FM integration of MT cos signal is sin theta divided by sin omega theta divided by omega. That is the integration part, and AM is constant. So now you can rearrange it. SFMT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KF AM divided by FM sin 2 pi FMT. This term can be written as beta KF AM divided by FM. So your signal will become SFMT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus beta sin 2 pi FMT. Here beta is your modulation index, that is defined as KF AM divided by FM. And if you remember, we defined KF into AM as del F. So beta becomes del F divided by FM. These equations are very useful in numericals actually. So you should mark these. Okay. Now what happens, depending upon the value of beta, you have two types of FM signal. One is NBFM, where beta is less than or equal to 1, narrow band FM, okay? And one is beta greater than 1, which is called as wide band FM, WBFM, okay? So our expression of FM signal changes depending upon the value of beta, okay? So we have our FM signal as AC cos 2 pi FCT plus beta sin 2 pi FMT. If you apply cos A plus cos B, you'll get AC cos 2 pi FCT cos beta sin 2 pi FMT minus AC sin 2 pi FCT sin beta sin 2 pi FMT. Now for, let's say you are representing this term beta sin 2 pi FMT as theta. So for NBFM, where beta is less than equal to 1, your beta is very very small, which means for small theta, cos theta will be approximately equal to 1 and sin theta will be approximately equal to theta. Means this guy will be equal to beta sin 2 pi FMT and this guy will be equal to 1. So you will get a new expression for NBFM, narrow band FM, that is AC cos 2 pi FCT minus AC beta sin 2 pi FCT sin 2 pi FMT. This is your expression for beta less than 1 or for narrow band FM. Okay. Okay, so one point I want to mention here, you have your signal now as NBFMT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT minus AC beta sin 2 pi FCT sin 2 pi FMT. Okay, so if you apply sin A sin B in this case, you will get AC cos 2 pi FCT as it is minus AC beta divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FMT, and this is AC beta divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FMT. So this is the expanded version of this. Now if you compare this signal with the standard AM signal, which is DSP FC signal, the expression of DSP FC which we had AC cos 2 pi FCT plus AC mu divided by 2 cos FC minus FMT plus AC mu divided by 2 cos FC plus FMT. 2 pi will come. 2 pi I have ignored. 2 pi is there. Okay. So if you compare these two signals, look similar to each other. Okay. The only difference is this sign in the lower sideband. So you can say single tone expressions of AM and NBFM will be same except 180 degree phase shift in lower sideband frequency component. So the spectrum of AM is this and spectrum of NBFM is this. So the only difference you can see, this is FC, FC plus FM, FC minus FM, FC, FC plus FM, FC minus FM. The lower sideband has negative amplitude. AC beta by 4, AC beta by 4, AC beta by 4, this is minus AC beta by 4, AC mu by 4, AC mu by 4, AC by 2. So you can see the only difference is in the lower sideband frequency component that there is a phase shift of 180 degree, means the negative amplitude. Okay, so you can think of it as a AM signal only. The only difference is the lower sideband has negative amplitude. Now let's see a few points about NBFM. So the bandwidth, if you have observed the spectrum for both AM and NBFM, the bandwidth required is same, that is 2FM and 2FM. In case of NBFM as well, it is 2FM. Okay, the magnitude spectrums of AM and NBFM will be same. If you will take the magnitude spectrum, it will look like AM signal only for NBFM. And power of NBFM, if you calculate, that is the power of carrier plus USB plus LSB. So we saw the amplitude in the FM signal expression, that AC was the amplitude of carrier, so AC square divided by 2R. AC beta divided by 2 was amplitude of USB, so AC square beta square divided by eta R is power, and minus AC beta divided by 2 was amplitude. If you take the square, it will come positive, so AC square beta square divided by eta. If you see, this is AC square common, we have taken AC square divided by 2R, 1 plus beta square divided by 2. So it looks like similar to what we had in AM. This is PC, 1 plus beta square divided by 2, there we had mu square divided by 2. So you can say the transmitted power and channel bandwidth requirement for NBFM and FM, NBFM and AM is same. Okay. So because of the high similarity of with AM, NBFM has less practical importance as compared to WBFM. So WBFM is more important in terms of practical scenario, and because of the high similarity with AM signal, NBFM is usually not given importance. Okay, so the power and the channel bandwidth are same for NBFM as we had in AM signal, which is DSB FC.